Hi everyone, Grant for the Flame Learning Channel. When performing any VFX or grading, either in the effects environment, timeline, or batch, one of the repetitive tasks between adjustments is reviewing what you have. In this video, you'll learn about the various player options for fast and easy reviewing. Oh, and by the way, the player options are available in all areas of Flame. This video is not footage specific, so you can use your own media to follow along. Now in the effects environment, here is our example sequence. We're looking at the result viewport, and the time bar is set to segment range. Now say for argument's sake, you already applied a timeline effects and made some grading or VFX decisions. So to review a shot, the easiest thing to do is just press play or hit the return keyboard shortcut. The segment plays through, but it stops at the end of the time bar. You can hit play again, and the playback will start from the beginning of the time bar. So that's the default behavior. If you wanted to alter the playback behaviors, just click and hold the play button to bring up the pop-up menu. So you can play forward or backward with the return and shift return keyboard shortcuts. The default playback is set to normal, and it will only play through the time bar once. So if you switch that to loop and press play, the range within the time bar will play and loop continuously. There is also the back and forth playback, but you can try that on your own. But the two options I want to point out is play all or play real time. Play all means that Flame will play all the frames, regardless of the frame rate. Whereas play real-time will attempt to respect and play at the set frame rate, therefore it may skip frames in order to do so. Now the default play mode is set to normal, but another alternative to define what you play can be based on a selection. Just select that option through the play pop-up menu. Now you're not going to notice a difference when viewing one shot with the segment range, so change the time bar to either timeline or storyboard range using the options pull-down menu. Secondly, change the viewport to the corresponding contextual view with the 4 keyboard shortcut toggle. Now at any point you press play, Flame will only play the currently selected segment. Even if you are somewhere else in the sequence, the positioner will jump and play back the selection. The other fact I'd like to point out is that the playback appears to start before the selection and end after the selection. This is not an error. This is your pre- and post-roll settings. By default, it is set to 30 frames. If you wish to alter this, you need to switch to the Timeline tab and call up the player's viewing settings. You can do this through the pull-down menu or press Alt-5. Under the playback header, you can set the pre-roll and post-roll to 0. Turn off the viewing settings and switch back to the Effects tab. When you press play again, only the actual frames of the selection will be played. Now I mentioned in the beginning of this video that these play controls are also available via the timeline. So you can select multiple segments in the sequence and play them back as part of a selection. This is not available in the effects environment because you can only have one main selection at a time. However, that becomes a non-issue because of the next play mode. Hold the play button down again and choose Custom from the pop-up menu. So now you get markers in the time bar, and you can define a custom range of frames to be considered during playback. Thinking about it, you could even fake a pre-roll and post-roll by overextending the in and out markers. So this is really handy, and you can even set a custom range within a single segment if you are just monitoring a few frames. And what is equally useful is if you move to different shots with the transition buttons or the up arrow and down arrow keyboard shortcuts, the custom range will move in relation to the newly selected clip in the storyboard. So you can set a custom range in any of the modules and monitor the frames that you want to see. Now, before we conclude this video, here are a couple of extra points worth remembering. Firstly, even though the player options are available in all modules, they are independent of each other. Whatever you set up in the effects environment will not be the same in the timeline or batch, but the settings are persistent in their respective modules. Secondly, I just want to remind you that even during playback, you can still adjust the various settings. So this allows you to play your frames back and see the changes as you make them. Just ensure auto key is off to avoid any keyframing issues. So up to this point in the series, we've covered navigation, sorting, filtering, and player controls. In the upcoming videos, we change the focus on how the effects tools work within the effects environment and cover the various workflows so you get the best out of the tools. Don't forget to also check out the other features, workflows, and enhancements to Flame 2019. Comments, feedback, and suggestions are always welcome and appreciated. Please subscribe to the Flame Learning channel for future videos, and thanks for watching.